want to hurt you in such a way, but there are so many fake Babajis are there. So there's a lot of confusion among the people, right?
That's true.
How do you think it's like, you know, like for a common man to distinguish that? And what sort of message you want to convey, even from the, like, you know, because you have higher level connections, right? So is there any way to control that, you know?
That's right. It's not how the person appears, and it's also not what he does that matters. There is some kind of authoritativeness behind everything. A person works in a country, he needs to follow the constitution of that country. Thus, he becomes a responsible citizen of that particular country to work with. And so also, when you are living here in this world, there is some authority behind which I think everybody should follow. That is our scriptures. So for us people coming from a tradition called Vaishnavism, we have authority behind us called Vedas. So Vedas talk about many things as how we have to conduct ourselves, how we have to be in the world, and how we have to see, do things also. So if one follows that Vedic dictums, I think we can take them authority. If they are not following, then let them be great in other senses. But we don't care.
Okay. So like in terms of succeeding in the US, right, because a lot of people, even for me, like it's just very difficult to understand, like, you know, Upanishad and all this, right?
Okay.
So what is the simple form, you know, like, you know, like you have like a lot of videos, I saw that, you know, like I try to understand 50%, some of them are like very critical, and I know like you are trying your level best to, you know, give good knowledge to the society to make that. But is there any simplest way, you know, like, I know there's nothing simple, but to make this society, you're trying hard, right? So is there anything else you're doing for the kids, especially for the youth, you know, like you're traveling the world and then you're trying, right? So what is the best, you know, like in like a 1 minute way to see that, oh, this is the way approach, you know, like I saw that your links and all. So
yes.
Is there anything else, like, you know, you're trying, you know, like your team, or is there any, you know?
What you expect to you, do that to others. I think that is what the Veda says in brief. That means you respect, probably you expect from people that they should respect you. They should not hurt you, either by word or deed or something like that. So you also should not hurt anybody. You should not do anything wrong to others. You should not grab anything from others, or you should not suppress anybody. You should not dominate anything, because you don't want that to happen to you from others. So don't do such things to others. That itself is the greatest message that Vedas gave to us. And that's what our gurus did. And we don't want to excavate, we don't want to create anything new to us, but we want to simply follow the words what our great gurus said. We want to follow the good path shown to us, to the world in general, by our great gurus. And at the same time, we want to be always humble to all the devotees.
So truly appreciate it, Swamiji. So, like, can you tell in 1 minute about the, you know, like the statue of equality you're trying?
Mm.
So, like, are you saying that, you know, like all community in terms of like irrespective of religion, is that what the purpose of that?
Because the statue of equality, what we call it, stands for the value of equality, basically. That means everybody in this world and all people in this world should be equally treated before God. In terms of their own abilities, yes, there may be ups and downs. They'll be obviously there everywhere. So one, because of his high intellectual ability, may be able to produce more and earn more and enjoy more. Somebody may be having that less amount of the brain capability, and he may be earning a bit lesser and just enjoying things. That's okay. But it doesn't mean that you have to disrespect others. It doesn't mean that you have to suppress others. So we have to feel that equality before God with everyone, and see that minimum things should be distributed equally for everyone. This is what the common law of the world. That's why our acharyas always said, usually people say, no, serving humanity is service to God. But our Acharya said in a different way. Man has taken probably this message, serving humanity, service to God, and started killing animals, killing birds, and cutting trees, and polluting the air, and spoiling the water, and causing the breach to the ozone, and stuff like that. But our Acharya has never said that, you know, you have to disrespect them. So, serving humanity alone never becomes service to God, because God is in everything, and He was the one who is responsible for everything to happen. So the message of our Acharyas and of course from the Vedas is that serve all beings as service to God. Because everything becomes a part of God. That means you do things good to anything. That means to keep it in its own status. That means if you keep a tree as it should grow well, that is a service to God, because God is there in that too.
Excellent point, Swamiji. And one last question is like, no, so now I don't want to talk about the age, but you look so young, and then you still, you know, like you're standing there for hours and hours, and I met you on Sunday also. And what is the secret? Is it a diet, or is the meditation, or is it like, no, like you know, like if you don't mind him?
don't do bad things is a secret of the good health. Don't think bad, that itself is a good secret to the health. Don't eat rough stuff and, you know, junk things, you know, that itself is a secret of the good health. So, do good, be good, always. I think everybody can live a healthy and, you know, happiest life. That's all it is.
Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you so much, Swamiji. Thank you so much.
హర్షధ్వానాలన్నీ అర్పితం. అందుకని గాయకుల కోసం పుట్టదు స్వామివారి పుట్టండి. అది సేవలో ఒక భాగం. ఇంకొక పాట వారు వినిపిస్తారు. ఈలోపుగా మీకు ఎగ్జామ్. అన్నమాచార్య స్వామి వారు వెంకటేశ్వర స్వామిని ఏమేమని అడ్రస్ చేశారు? పురుషోత్తమ, సిద్ధమంత్రమ, చింతామణి, ఇంకా కొన్ని ఉన్నాయి. ఒక మిలియన్ సంపాదించిన కలగని అనుభూతి ఈ పాటలో ఉంది. జాగ్రత్తగా దాన్ని మీరు వినండి. అన్ని ప్రతి పదాన్ని అనుభవించండి. తెలుగు వారు అయినందుకు మీరు అనుభవించాలి, నెక్స్ట్ జనరేషన్స్కి ఇవ్వాలి. ఆయన పేరు ఏమని, దేవుడి పేరు ఏమన్నా, అద్భుతమైన పాట. వారు కరెక్ట్గా దాన్ని వెంకట పెళ్లి కొడుకుని అడ్రస్ చేయడం కోసం తీసుకున్నారు ఈ పాట. పెళ్లి కొడుకులో ముందు మనం చూసేవేండి, అన్ని అందం చూడాలి, ఆస్తులు చూడాలి, ఆయనకు ఉండే ఎడ్యుకేషన్ చూడాలి, అన్ని చూసాక మన అమ్మాయిని ఇవ్వాలి. మీరంతా కన్యా దాతలు. అలమేలు మంగన పద్మావతీదేవిని స్వామికి మీద సమర్పించబోతున్నారు మీ అమ్మాయి ఇవ్వాలి. కన్యాదానం చేయడం కోసం కూర్చున్నారు. మీ అమ్మాయిలు ఇచ్చే ముందే అబ్బాయి వివరాలు తెలుసుకోవాలి. ఇప్పటిదాకా వారు ఓపెన్గా చెప్పారు అబ్బాయి వివరాలు. అందులో మొదటిది పురుషోత్తమ. అంటే ఏమిటి? పురు అంటే బోలెడు, తరగనంత. పురు సనోత్ బోలెడంతా ఇచ్చేవాడు కనుక ఆయన పేరు పురుషుడు. మనం కూడా ఇస్తాం. $100 ఉంటే $10 ఇస్తే 90 మిగులుతుంది మన దగ్గర. అంటే మన దగ్గర తరుగుతుంది. ఇస్తే ఎంత ఇచ్చినా తరగదు ఆయన. నిన్న సోలార్ ఎనర్జీ వచ్చింది ఇవాళ దగ్గర. నిన్న గాలి సప్లై చేశాడు ఇవాళ గాలి దేవుడు వీకెండ్ అడగదు. ఆయన సిస్టంలో వీకెండ్ లేదు. ఎంత గొప్పవాడు ఉంటాడు, ఎంత శక్తివంతుడు ఉంటాడు, ఎంత జ్ఞాని ఉంటాడు. తంబు స్కాన్ చేస్తాము, ఇలాంటిది మళ్ళీ ఇంకో చోట ఉండదు. ఎంత డిజైన్, ఎంత గొప్ప డిజైన్, అన్లాక్ చేయలేదు. ఆ టెక్నాలజీ తెలిసి యూజ్ చేసుకోవడం గొప్ప. పెద్ద పెద్ద దేశాలన్నీ వాడుతున్నాయి. ఆయన దగ్గర కాపీరైట్స్ మాత్రం దేవుడే. అలాంటి మహాజ్ఞాని, మహా గొప్పవాడు, ఎంత ఇచ్చినా తరగని వాడు. ఎంత ఇచ్చినా తరగని ఆస్తున్నప్పుడు మనకు కూడా చూడండి, సహస్రాబ్దికి స్పాన్సర్ చేయండి అన్నాం అనుకోండి, ఓ $1,200,000 తీసేస్తే ఆయనకి ఏం పెద్ద నష్టం కలగదు. ఉన్నా అని ఆయన ఎలాగ అనుభవించాడు. కానీ తీయాలంటే ఆలోచిస్తున్నాం, తీస్తే అమ్మ ఎలాగ ఉంది. అంటే ఇవ్వడానికి ఒక లోపల ఉంటుంది. కొంతమంది ఇస్తారు. ఆయన ఇచ్చిన వాడని మన స్టేజ్ మీద పిలిపించి మాల వేస్తాం, సోయండి సోండి, ఎంత స్పాన్సర్ చేశారు, అంత చేశారు. అంటే ఇచ్చిన వాడని పోగొడతాం. ఇక్కడ దేవుడు ఇస్తాడు, ఇచ్చేవాడు, తీసుకున్నవాడని పోగొడతాడు. నా దగ్గరకు వచ్చి ఫలాని వాడు అడిగాడు, నాకు సంతానం కావాలని అడిగారు, నాకు వీసా కావాలని అడిగారు, నాకు మోక్షం కావాలని అడిగారు అని నన్ను అడిగారు వాడు నా దగ్గరకు వచ్చి అని ఆప్యాయత చూపిస్తాడట. ఉదారా సర్వ ఏవైతే ఆర్తో జిజ్ఞాసు అర్థాధిజ్ఞాని నాలుగు రకాలుగా అడిగేవాడు. అంటే క్యూలో ఉన్నవాడు నాలుగు డివైడ్ చేస్తాడు, లక్ష మందిలో ఒక్కడు ఒక పైకి వస్తాడు, ఓ 90,000 మంది ఇంకోవైపు పెడతారు, ఓ 10,000 మంది ఇంకో దాంట్లో ఉంటారు. మొదటి వాడు అర్థార్థి, స్వామి నా దగ్గర 1,00,000 రూపాయలు ఉన్నాయి కానీ దీనికి ఒక 10 లక్షలు చేయాలి, నేను ఎలాగైనా వ్యాపారం ప్రారంభిస్తున్నాను అని పెంచండి. అయినా నాకు సంతానం ఉంది, బంధువులు ఉన్నారు, ఇంకా బలం పెరగాలి, ఆశీర్వదించండి. కండబలం ఉంది, ఇంకొంచెం పెరగాలి. బుద్ధి బలం ఉంది, పెరగాలి. ఉద్యోగం ఉంది, పెరగాలి. ఇలాగా ప్రతి ఒక్కరు దేవుడు ఉన్నదాన్ని పెంచమని అడుగుతారు. వీళ్ళందరిని ఏమంటారు? మనందరినీ ఏమంటారు? వాళ్ళ వాళ్ళంటే మనమే కదా, మనందరినీ ఏమంటారు? అర్థార్థి కావాలని కోరేవాడు, ఉన్న లెవెల్ కట్టి ఇంకా లేచలేదు. ఇంకొంతమంది అంటారు ఆర్తు, అయ్యో అనేవాడు. ఎందుకు అయ్యో అంటున్నారు? ఏదో పోయింది కావాలి, ఇదివరకు ఆరోగ్యం బాగుంది ఇప్పుడు పోయింది కావాలి, ఇదివరకు ఆస్తి ఉంది పోయింది కావాలి, ఇలా పోయింది ఏదో కావాలి. దీని వీళ్ళంతా ఏమంటారు? ఆర్తులు. ఈ రెండు కేటగిరీలో చేరిపోతాం మనం. లక్ష మంది కోటి మంది దర్శించాలి తిరుపతి వెంకన్న అంటే ఎవరు పోయేది దానికోసం కాదు, అందరు వెళ్ళేది ఇంకా ఈ రెండింటిలో వెళ్ళిపోయారు. ఆర్తో అర్థార్థి. ఇంకొకటి ఉన్నారు జిజ్ఞాసు, వాడు ఈ లోకంలో వస్తువులు అడగరు, దేవుణ్ణి అడగరు. సెల్ఫ్ రియలైజేషన్, శరీరం కంటే నేను వేరట, ఆత్మట, జ్ఞాన ఆనంద స్వరూపుండట, చిన్మయం ఉండట, నన్ను నేను తెలుసుకోవాలంది, హెల్ప్ చేస్తావా, హెల్ప్ చేస్తావా అంటున్నారు. కానీ దేనికోసం? వరల్డ్ థింగ్స్ కోసం కాదంటే దేవుడి కోసం కాదు. వాడు కేటగిరీ వెళ్ళి వాడిని కైవల్యం ఉంటారు, అది మూడవది. సో మొదటి దాంట్లో 90,000 మంది వచ్చారు, 1,00,000. మిగతా ఇంకో 9,990 ఇంకో దానికి వెళ్ళారు, 8,900 కైవల్యంలోకి వెళ్ళారు. ఒక్కడే ఉంటాడు, ఉంటాడో ఉంటాడు తెలియదు. వాడు మాత్రం ఎవరు? దేనికోసం వచ్చారు? నీకోసం. ఎవరు వారు? ఈయన కదా, దేవుడు కావాలన్నా, దేవుడు ఇచ్చేది కావాలని, లడ్డు కావాలన్నాడు, కోరికలు కోరు, ఇంకోటి కోరు, ఏం కోరుతారు? చాలా సేపు అయింది పడుకోసం. సుప్రభాతం కొంచెం నెమ్మదిగా రండి, తొందర ఏం లేదు, పడుకొని వింటారు, అలసిపోయారు. పబ్లిక్ వచ్చారు, వస్తారు లేదు, వస్తూనే ఉంటారు, కాసేపు ఆగండి, ఆయన మాత్రం రెస్ట్ ఇవ్వండి. ఇలా తమరు నారాయణ రామానుజు గారు, తమరు చిన్న జీయర్ స్వామి, వీళ్ళంతా కోట్ల మందిలో ఒకరు వస్తారు. ఇంతమంది నాకు అభిమాన పాత్రలే, కానీ ఉదారా సర్వే ఏవైతే, వీళ్ళంతా నన్ను అడిగారు కనుక చాలా ఉదారు అన్నారు. జ్ఞానీయులు ఆత్మైవమేవతి, వీళ్ళందరిలో జ్ఞాని ఉన్నాడు, నేను కావాలని నన్ను తప్పించేవాడు. వాడు చాలా ఇష్టం, మామేవ అనుత్తమంగతి, నువ్వే కావాలంటున్నాడు. సో పిల్లలంతా చుట్టూ 4 పిల్లలు ఉన్నారు, ఒకడు ఆస్తి అడిగి వెళ్ళాడు, ఒకటి చాక్లెట్ ఇస్తే వెళ్ళాడు, ఒకటి ఇంకోటి అడితే వెళ్ళాడు, ఇంకో పిల్లవాడు మాత్రం ఇంకా అలాగే ఉన్నాడు, అమ్మ కిచెన్లో క్లీన్ చేస్తుంది, చుట్టూ తిరుగుతున్నాడు. ఎందుకు రావు నా పడుకు వాళ్ళు వెళ్ళారు కదా అంటే బోర్ మీతోనే ఉంటాను అంటున్నాడు. ఎందుకట అంటే బోర్ కాదు, అమ్మ కూడా కష్టపడుతుంది, నేను కూడా హెల్ప్ చేయను డిష్ వాష్ చేయను. అప్పుడు అమ్మ అందరినీ సమంగా ప్రేమించిన వాళ్ళని కొంచెం ఎక్కువ ఉంటుంది. అలాగా ఎంత ఇచ్చినా తరగనివాడు, ఎంతో ఇవ్వాలనే ప్రేమ ఉన్నవాడు, ఆయన పేరు పరమ పురుషోత్తమ. అలాగే పురుషోత్తమ, ఉత్తమ అంటే ఉత్ ఉత్తర ఉత్తమ, ఉత్ అంటే ఒక స్థితి, ఉత్తర అంటే వాడి కంటే విడిపోతాడు, ఉత్తమ అంటే అందరిలో గొప్ప. ఎంత ఇచ్చినా తరగనివాడు పురుషోత్తమ. పిలవండి ఒకసారి గట్టిగా, పురుషోత్తమ అని వారు అంటారు, మీరు అనండి ఎలా అనాలి,
స్థుతులనే అనాలి అందరూ.
పిల్లలందరినీ కాపాడాలనుకుంటున్నారు కదా, ఈ పాట నేర్పించండి. మంత్రం కాపాడుతుంది, చింతామణి, అద్భుతమైనటువంటి భావాలు మరొక పాట వినిపిస్తారు శ్రవణ జరు. ఈసారి జాగ్రత్తగా వినండి, మళ్ళీ అడుగుతుంది ఎగ్జామ్ ఉంటుంది. మీకు అర్థమయ్యే భాషలోనే పాడతా పురందన యుగంధర స్వామి వారు విద్యా పెట్ట అంటున్నారు కాబట్టి ఆయన సంస్కృతంలో పాడారు మాటలా తెలుస్తుంది అనుకుంటా. త్యాగరాజ స్వామి వారు గారి అద్భుతమైన కీర్తన, శ్రీ రఘుకులమందు పుట్టి నీవు సీతను చేకొని రామచంద్ర. మా అమ్మాయిని ఎలా చేకొనాలో అని చెప్పారు, అది ఇప్పుడు నేను మీకు వినిపిస్తాను.
శ్రీ రఘుకులమందు పుట్టి నీవు నడిచి వస్తుంటేనే నీ పెళ్లి కూతురుగా
ఆ వయ్యారు ఆ కళ రాముల వారు కన్నెత్తి నేను చూడాలనుకున్నటువంటి రాముల వారి ఒక శ్రీనివాసులు నేను చూడాలా అనుకున్న వారు కూడా ఆ కళా వైభవం వైభవం చూసి ఒక్కసారి అలా కన్నెత్తి చూశారు. ఆ అద్భుతమైనటువంటి వర్ణనని ఇక్కడ వర్ణించారు అన్నమాచార్య గారు. అది ఇప్పుడు నేను చూపిస్తాను. తర్వాత కళ్యాణ కీర్తన ఒకరికొకరు ఒకరికొకరు ఎలా ఉన్నారు అనేది కూడా మీకు ఈ సందర్భంగా వర్ణిస్తాను.
పురుషం జగదే అవి బ్రతక్ నారేశ్వర మన చేతుల వాద్యములై మారు రోగుచుండగా మన కన్నుల వెలుగు ఎల్ల హారతిచ్చుచుండగా. మీకు హారత లేవు, మీ దగ్గర వెలిగించడానికి పర్మిషన్ లేదు, కానీ మీ కళ్ళలో ఒక జ్యోతి ఉంది, దాంతో దేవుడికి హారతపడ్డాడు. మన చేతుల వాద్యములై మారు రోగుచుండగా మన ఒడలు శరీరం బడలిక విడి పులకరించుచుండగా. కళ్యాణ కార్యక్రమాలు వాళ్ళు ఈ పాట నేను 1000 కలశాల స్నానం శ్రీరామచంద్రుడు చేసినట్టే రాశాను. ఇప్పుడు మీరంతా అలా ఇక్కడి నుంచి పూజ అనుభవించండి. నిత్య పూజలు ఇవి కానీ ఇప్పుడు వాళ్ళు చెప్తారు కాసేపాటి ఎలా చేయాలి నిత్య పూజలు. ఇప్పటిదాకా మీరు విన్న పాట ఉంది, ఆ పాట ఏమిటి ఏం చెప్పారు తల్లి చెప్తారా? ఇక్కడ జరుగుతున్న కార్యక్రమం చెప్పారు. చివరి పదం తీసుకున్నాం, మెరుపు మేఘము వలె మెరసినట్టుందట. మెరుపు మేఘం, మేఘం నీలి వర్ణంలో ఉంటుంది. ఇంతకుముందు గారవించి దప్పి తీర్చు కాలమేఘమా అన్నాను దేవుడిని, అనండి ఒకసారి. గారవించి దప్పి తీర్చు బాగా దాహమైన వేళ నీలి మేఘం, ఏదో కాలేమేఘ కాలేమేఘ పానీకో బరిసావో పాట ఫేమస్. వాడంతా పల్లె జనాలంతా నానే అవస్థ పడుతుంటే మేఘాలన్నీ కప్పితే వర్షం పడబోతుందేమో అని ఆనందంలో వాడు పాడతారు. మనం కూడా బీడువారిన భూములు, ఈ శక్తి ఈ మనస్సు చిలకలంటాం చూడండి, పంటలు పడ్డం వైరు భూములు డ్రై అయింది. దేనివల్ల? వేడి. ఏ వేడి? మూడు రకాల వేడి, ఆధ్యాత్మిక అనటి, ఆధిదైవిక, ఆది భౌతిక. భౌతికమైన వస్తువులా కలిగే దుఃఖాలు కొన్ని, దొంగలు కత్తి రాయి యాక్సిడెంటల్ థింగ్స్ వాటి వల్ల దుఃఖాలు ఉన్నాయి. ఇది కాకుండా ఆది దైవిక, స్నో రెయిన్ సమ్మర్ వర బాగా గాలు వరదలు వీటి వల్ల కలిగే దుఃఖాలు కొన్ని, వాటి వల్ల సమరత్వం. వాటి ఏమంటారు? దేవత వల్ల కోర్టు కడి కేసు ఏమీ లేదు, సునామీ వచ్చింది ఎవరికి కేసు పెడతాం, ఎవరి మీద పెడతాం, భూకంపం వచ్చింది, ఇవన్నీ ఆది దైవిక. తాపాలు, తాపం అంటే దుఃఖాన్ని కలిగించాలి. ఆది ఆత్మిక తాపాలు, ఏసీ రూమ్లో ఉన్నా మంచిది, వేడి రూమ్లో ఉన్నా బయట చల్లదనం ఉన్నా మనకు బాధించట్లేదు, ఇక్కడ కత్తులు కడాలు గుచ్చుకునేవి లేవు, కార్పెట్ మీద ఉన్నాం. సో ఆది భౌతిక తాపాలు లేవు, ఆది దైవిక తాపాలు లేవు. కానీ ఇంకా బాగున్నారా అంటే అంటున్నాం. ఎవరైనా అడగండి లోకంలో బాగున్నారా అండి అంటే బాగున్నాం, పబ్లిక్లో అడిగి పక్క వారు అడిగించాను బాగున్నాం కానీ అంటే వేరే కంట్రోల్ అడిగింది కానీ దానికి నిర్వేదం అయిపోయింది, దాన్ని ప్రకటించే విధానం ఆ సౌండ్ ఉంది కదా దానికి నిర్వేదం అంటారు సంస్కృతం. అలాంటి నిర్వేదంతో బాధపడుతున్నాం. ఈ శరీరం అనేటువంటి మనస్సు అనేటువంటి భూమి డ్రై అయిపోయింది, దాని మీద వర్షం పడాలి, మొలకలు రావాలండి. భక్తి మొలకలు రావాలంటే ఏం పడాలి? గారవించి దప్పి తీర్చు కాలమేఘమా అని గట్టిగా పిలిస్తే ఆ కాలమేఘం ఎదురుగా ఉన్నాడు ఏడు గొడవల పైన మేఘం. అలాంటి స్వామి యొక్క కృప అనే వర్షం మన మీద పడి మన మనస్సులన్నీ కూడా వెట్టయిపోతాయి. అప్పుడు వాటిలో అన్నీ చేసే వెట్టయిపోయింది, మొదట క్లాప్స్ కొట్టలేదు డ్రై అయింది, రెండవసారికి సగం కొట్టారు కొంచెం మెత్తబడింది, ఇప్పుడు బాగా మెత్తబడిపోయింది వెంటనే క్లాప్స్ కొట్టేశారు. అప్పుడు దానిలో మన భక్తి సస్యాన్ని పండించవచ్చు. ఆ స్వామి కళ్యాణ మహోత్సవాన్ని స్వీకరించడం కోసం సిద్ధపడ్డారు. విశ్వక్సేన పూజ అయింది, ఆ స్వామి విశ్వసేన యొక్క అనుగ్రహం మీకు అక్షత రూపంలో వస్తుంది. విశ్వసేన వారు ఎవరో ఏమిటో విజ్ఞాన్ని ఎలా పోగొడతారో అని చాలాసార్లు విన్నారు. తర్వాత సుదర్శన స్వామి పరశుద్ధ ఆహ్వానం చేసి సుదర్శన గాయత్రి చేతి దాన్ని అభిమంత్రించి కళ్యాణ వేదిక నంటే ఆ శక్తి
జగత్ అభిప్రదజ్ఞా కళ్యాణ మహోత్సవ కార్యక్రమంలో భాగంగా మాంగళ్య ధారణ జరుగుతుంది. శ్రీనివాసుడు వెంకటేశ్వర స్వామి తన యొక్క అనుగ్రహంతో అర్చక ముఖంగా శ్రీదేవి భూదేవి అమ్మవార్ల యొక్క కంఠసీమయందు మాంగళ్య ధారణ చేయిస్తున్నాడు. క్షీరోదమనాయ ఫలరూపే మధుద్విష నమశ్చంద్ర సహోదరే నమస్తే అమృతయోదయే సముద్రతనయే మాతర్లక్ష్మీస్వాం ప్రార్థయామ్యహం మాంగళ్యసూత్రం దేవేన యుష్మత్కంఠ సమర్పణే నియోనితోహం పధ్యామి గృహాణ పరమేశ్వరీ గోవింద ృప్యాణి దక్షిణా ప్రతిగ్రహే మనసశ్చిత్తమాగోతిం వాచః సత్యమసీమహి పశూనాం రూపమన్నస్య యశస్వీ శ్రీయతాం మయి యథాహమస్యాద్రిపక్క స్త్రియే పుమాన్ యథా స్త్రీ తృప్తి పుంసి ప్రియే ప్రియా ఏవం భగస్య తృప్యాణి యజ్ఞస్య కామ్య ప్రియః దదామీత్యగ్నిర్వదతే తథేతి వాయురాహతత్ హంతేతి సత్యం చంద్రమా
పెట్టి కూర్చో పెద్ద పేరు నమో కాలమేడ పెట్టి కూర్చో పెరుగల జవరాలే పెట్టి కూర్చో పెద్ద పేరు Thank you. Yesterday was Gita Jayanti, the birthday of Bhagavad Gita, and we were blessed to chant the whole Bhagavad Gita in the ashram, and it was really, really enjoyable. And today is Ekadasi, the following day of Ekadasi. Today we have now organized here Sri Srinivasa Kalyanam. You know why? Because tomorrow is going to be the birth star of a great alwar, and his name is Tiru Mangai Alwar. He is a great saintly person. You might have seen many temples in South India, right from Srirangam, which is having a big setup and big compound walls, probably having 24 feet of height, and protecting the temple, and also having lots and lots of beauty in it. Do you know who made all those temples? That was the Alwar who born tomorrow, whose birthday comes tomorrow. His name was, they call him as Parakalam in Sanskrit, and in Tamil they call him as Tirumangai Alwar. Very, very great person. Probably the one who toured almost all the places in Bharat, and also in Nepal, and visited the temples there and sung the glory of all those deities. He composed many songs, almost 1400 songs, revealing the Vedic secrets and lucifying the greatness of God. An Alwar means a great devotee who dived deep into the ocean of his great tribes. If we consider the divine qualities of God are just like a big ocean, there are great people who dive deep into those qualities and experienced them, and then came out and shared those experiences with people. They were not able to contain in themselves. They sang the glories of whatever the experiences they have in there. They became a beautiful songs. There's no unnecessary stuff in those songs, and there is absolutely no exaggeration whatsoever. But whatever is there that was sung by them, of course, they're born in a place where Tamil language was in use. So, the songs became Tamil songs. Tamil songs are considered as pasuras in Sanskrit language. You know, we call them as shlokas, and in Telugu we call them as padyams. So also in Tamil, a song is called as pasura. So they sung in Tamil pasuras the glory of God, which is very difficult to understand if we go through the Sanskrit literature. And if we go into the Vedic literature also, it was very, very difficult to understand. Such great glory of God was sung by them in a regional language, in a local language, in mostly in Tamil. So if we sing those songs, we really experience so great depths of His grace and the mercy of God, how He saves souls, how He blesses us, and how He comes down to this earth, how He conducts many activities, and His pure excellence, grace on all of us is something that we are able to experience in those songs. Most of the times, God, after coming down to this earth, He talks to people. He does many activities. There are two types of incarnations. What people call as incarnation, but we call it an appearance. Appearance of God. He comes down to this earth in two forms. One is a moving form. Another one is a non-moving form. Moving form is called Chalamurti. Non-moving form is called Achalamurti. God comes in both the forms. We heard stories about Lord Ramachandra, Lord Krishna, and Narasimha, Varaha, Vamana, etc. These are also appearances of God, but they are moving avatars of the Lord. But there are many, many avatars which are not moving, like what we see the deities in temples. They are not moving, but it is an appearance of God. He chose a form depending upon the need of the particular place and particular time. Once it was a time to come as a man, so He chose to become Brahma, and then He did something. It was a time when He wanted to show the divine powers, so He chose to come as Lord Krishna and did some activity. And when it was another occasion when He wants to just eliminate a few demons like Hiranyakashipu, etc., so He chose to become Narasimha. The need was like that, so He chose to appear in such a way where the lion head and human body, something like that. It depends what kind of need it is during that particular time, so He comes like that. But there is a rule. If He comes as a moving form, in a moving form, then obviously whatever the rules of the particular form, He also follows them. Any moving form on this earth comes down to here, I think we should go again from here, right? Anybody takes birth here, again should depart from this place. That's the rule of this land. Though it is made by Him, but He follows that rule also without any hesitation. When He came here as a man, He lived like a man. And again He left this bird also like a man. When he comes here, but he very strictly follows the rules whatsoever. So any moving form is like that. He came like Lord Krishna as a moving avatar, and he lived for 125 years, and then he left this world. Also, he disappeared again from here. That's the rule. So a moving object comes and goes, whereas a non-moving object, like inert objects, they never go. They will be here forever. So for some people who wants him to be like that, he comes in that form also. But still he is he only. Whether he moves or he doesn't move, but he always he only, no? So if it is fire and you touch it, it burns. So also God. So in whatever form he comes, but he has his own abilities and his own grace showers on us. So many a time he chose to be in non-moving avatars, which we call as archa avatar. What we see in a temple, we call them as deities, right? We call them as vigrahas also. Many people think, after all, this is made of stone. Okay. Or this is made of metal. Yes, one. For a common man, it's a piece of stone or it's a piece of metal. But only those people will be able to understand the grace of God, even there whose hearts are so ripened with divine love, what we call as a bhakti. For a common man, only the superficial form is visible, but for great-hearted people, they are able to see the inner core. Even the grace of God also, they are able to experience there. And with such people, even he communicates, he speaks. Sometimes he directly speaks, but the very common rule is he doesn't speak directly when he is in the form of archa. He speaks through someone. So he poses himself on somebody and then thus he speaks and he communicates whatever he wants to. So like that, God communicated many times through this archa form. How many of you visited Tirumala? Great. The most of you might have visited. And do you know Lord Srinivasa was talking to people? Did you hear any stories like that? He used to. Of course. The story of Lord Srinivasa, as per our scriptures, started 5,000 years ago. According to Puranas, like Varaha Purana, Brahmanda Purana, and Brahmavaivarta Purana, Skanda Purana, Padma Purana, Vamana Purana. So there are almost 11 Puranas, and also another scripture called Sesha Dharma. In all these 12 scriptures, the mention about Lord Srinivasa is there during the first century of this Kali Yuga. He appeared on this earth. Do you know what yuga this is? What era we are living in? This is called Kali Yuga. How many years passed after starting the Kali Yuga? 5,118 years. Just 3000 BC, the Kali Yuga started. Okay? So, during the first century, it seems, Lord Srinivasa appeared on the earth. That's what the Purana very clearly mentions, and also the location. In Varaha Purana, it is said, The location was given like this. From the Himalayas towards the south, and from the sea towards the west, after these many yojanas, there is a hill called Venkatadri. That's how the description goes. That means they know the longitude and latitude also. So that's how it is given. They started from Himalayas, taking it as a landmark. And from there, coming down south, these many yojanas. In those days, they used to call them yojanas. You know, we don't know exactly that what a yojana means, how much a yojana matters. But when we look at the Nala Setu, you know Nala Setu? What people today call is Ram Setu. You know, they bridge between Bharat and Sri Lanka. Yeah, between Bharat and Sri Lanka, there is a man-made bridge on the land and covering the sea. Of course, it was measured with a timeline, and they found it's 17.5 million years. It was made before 17.5 million years, which more or less goes at par with the age which we look at the Rama's age in Treta Yuga, because 864,000 years is Dwapara Yuga, and in Treta Yuga it is another about approximately another 864,000 years of age, and if you add both of them, then it goes, I think, 1.7 million, I think, not 17 million. Huh? 1.7 million, yeah, not 17 million. 1.7 million years. Padhir Lakshal, yeah, more or less like that, 1.75 million years. Yeah. And in Kali Yuga it is 5,000 years, so if you add all these things, it more or less comes to 1.75 million years. So the NASA people, when first said, then our people started discovering that. They have given the age of that was just like 1.75 million years ago. There is a man-made bridge called Adam's Bridge, and it is the man-made one. So the man's history should be rewritten, because the man made that, that means man was existing there. But according to them, man was not at all existing before 10,000 years, and they no technology available with them, and so on and so forth. So when they found this bridge, they thought it is time for rewriting the man's history of his appearance on this earth. Later somehow it was removed from their website, because somebody started questioning many things, and then I don't know why they removed it, but we don't know. But it is removed. But still, the bridge is there. And it is made by a man, you know? So it's a kind of evidence. When you look at the bridge, the width and the length of the bridge, it is almost 33 kilometers of length and 3.3 kilometers of width. That is how the bridge is there. And if we look into Sri Ramayana, Vanaras made a bridge under the guidance of Rama and one of the monkeys called Nala. Nala was the architect and Nila was the engineer. Both were of course monkeys, Under their guidance, the bridge was built in 5 days, it seems. Only in 5 days. And there is a description as how they made it. Then the people who made a survey on that also said the bridge now, which is existing, is exactly like that, like some stones, some wood, again stones layer, again wood, then mortar. They have some system as how it is built up. And they said it is exactly like that. Very, very strong. But when they measured it, it is 1:10 proportion. That is 33 miles of length and 3.3 miles of width. Exactly it is like that. In Sri Ramayana also, it is mentioned like 100 yojanas of length and 10 yojanas of width. Then it's what? How much it is? 1:10. 1:10. Proportion. That's how it is made. But basing on that, then we thought maybe yojana we have to think about what a yojana means. One yojana, not one yojana. 1 mile means maybe it is 3 yojanas. Then it matches. If we take that 3 yojanas as a mile, then it is 100, that means 99. It is 10 yojanas width, that means 3 miles, 3.3 miles of width. It matches exactly. So yojanas means probably 3 yojanas may make 1 mile. Let us take that way. Lord Srinivasa's appearance on the seven hills was mentioned like that. From the Himalayas, you have to come down towards Assam, these many yojanas, and from the East Sea, you have to go towards the West, these many yojanas, and there is a hill called Venkatadri, and Srinivasa, when came down to this earth, chose that to be a boat. He first landed on the seven hills. That's how it is mentioned. But they have given a day on which he first stepped on that. Do you know that day? Now, it was Monday. On a Monday of Bhadrapada month, and on rising moon, what you call the Shukla Paksha, and it is a Dwadasi, and a Somavasara, they call it a Monday, right? On a Monday, he first stepped on the hill. It is what the Purana says. Actually, keeping this in view only, later Ramanuja made a rule which is to be followed on the hill. I will tell you about it after some time. But Lord Srinivasa came as a moving avatara. That means he walked on that. It was then he chose a fair lady as his mother to take care of him. And that was Gokulamata. And then he was under her care for long. And then, of course, we know the story that he got married with Padmavati Devi. And it is only that avatara, Lord Srinivasa, where there are two features. Moving feature and then non-moving feature also. There are other avatars like Rama, Krishna, Narasimha, and etc. etc. There is only one feature that he came as a moving avatara, and then he completed that. Now we consecrated deities, and then we are feeling that avatara there. But with Lord Srinivasa, it's a different story. He came as a moving avatar, and he himself chose to appear as a non-moving avatar, and then he became like that. Do you have any clue that why he chose to be like that? To fulfill his mother, oath, mother's oath. Two wives, right? Not exactly. That is where we are. We worship Lord Srinivasa, but we do not study the story of Lord Srinivasa. You ask a Christian, he knows everything about his Christ. You ask an Islamic guy, he knows everything about his worshiping deity. But you ask some of our people, they say, something, something, something. We need to study our studies. Whatever you are doing, try to understand exactly what it is. Try to understand what you are, what your culture is, where you are standing. It's our minimum duty, my friends, to know about your own progeny and about your own deities, whomever it is you are worshipping. Don't see movies and start talking something about it. Many people nowadays say about Rama because they saw something on the TV screen about Rama's story, and then they start talking about Rama. They saw Mahabharata on TV and they start talking about it. You see that, enjoy it. But to know exactly what it is, read the original works and try to understand what they are. It's really always good. At least when your kids ask, hey dad, what it is, then at least you will be able to say the correct story. Not something story built up this way and that way. And all of us worship Lord Venkatesh, surprisingly. We all want him, we all want his grace, but we don't want to know what exactly he is. So, I suggest, read the story of Lord Srinivasa, and of course, there are nice books which collected all the stories related to Srinivasa right from Puranas, and then gave with the right translation also. And then, whatever happened exactly during the 11th and 12th centuries, when again the temple has been revived and presented as we see today, by Ramanujacharya, as what exactly and how it was given, that also is presented very well. And you can just read it and understand that. Okay? But anyway, I give you just a few details about it. Lord was coming up to that mountain since many, many millions of years. Acha, by the way, let me ask you a question. Do you have an idea that when the life started on the earth? Before how many years? You are right. 2 billion years ago. 2,000 million years before. This is probably what the present day science talks about. But this is what exactly our scriptures talk about. Our Panchangam also says the same thing. Of course, they never give an odd number, they give exact number. it is 1,958 million. Okay, and 18 years before. That's how the figure is given. I think if you see the Panchangams, probably every year during Ugadi you read, at the very first page on itself, they give when exactly the present creation started. Present creation. I mention it specifically because it's not the first creation and it's happening on and on. Probably even before also it was there. But the present creation started those many years before. They give in crores. 195 crores. 58 lakhs. And 85,118 years before. That's how they give years. It is happening every year. They add every year. It's not somebody created today. And since ages, people started calculating and giving that age. That's how it comes to us. Even the Panchayatam also is like that. Anyway, the story is pretty interesting. There was a great scientist in those days called Hiranyaksha, who wanted to make a trial on the planetary system, how the gravitational force works. As a result of that, it seems the Earth came out of her orbit and it was gone into the space, sublime. It was then God has taken an appearance called Varaha Avatara, Sveta Varaha Avatara. I mean, it's a divine boar which is having, you know, beautiful tusks also. And with that avatara, he again was holding the earth and brought her back to her own orbit and refixed her there. We may think it is it possible? The boar means adavipandi. You know, right? Not ordinary pig. It is a boar is something which moves only in the forest. The back of which is short and head is long, and it is having the tusks also, and it is very wild. So he took that form because the hair and tusks of that particular animal are useful as anti-gravitational material. Even our hair also is like that, but very little. But the boar's tusks and boar's hair is very, very precious, which is of course taken by the people who work on that field. So he took that form and brought the earth back and kept there. But after refixing the earth in her own place, he wanted to be on that earth for some time as an avatar. And then he selected the seven hills, which we call today as Venkatadri, his place to stay and where he was staying constantly. Since then, that means almost 2 billion years ago, it happened. There is a rock arch on Tirumala Hills. How many of you have seen that rock arch? It is called Sila Toranam. There, it actually it is the place through which he entered and stayed there on the hill. The rock art is made there. And if you see there, the archaeology department people, actually carbon dating was done to the rock art, and they kept a board there saying that this belongs to 1500 million years. That's how just they kept the carbon dating report. 1500, when they said, that means 150 crores of years. It's more or less equal to 200 crores. No? When you've gone to beyond 100 years, no matter how many years you go, no? Very little variation between 150 and 200 crores of years. No? Then came Varaha, was staying there, appearing on and off to people of those ages. And the Purana also gives a description during different age periods, different eras, when there were great kings and others going there and praying to the Lord, he was appearing in different forms. Even Devatas also seems went there and prayed for his grace, and there he came and appeared. Brahma first went there and did penance, for him God appeared there, it seems. And Rudra, the Lord Shiva, went there and prayed for his grace, and Srinivasa appeared for him. And Shiva's son, who is called as Kumar Swami Skanda, also went and did tapas there in a place called Kumaradhara, and for his sake, Lord Srinivasa appeared and blessed him. All, even Vayu Devata went there and did penance, and for him also Lord Srinivasa appeared there. But all these guys did the tapas with Ramanama. That is beautiful. The mantra which they have taken was Rama mantra. Vayu was chanting Rama mantra, and Lord Shiva was chanting Rama mantra. When Kumar Swami, that means his own son, was suffering from some kind of problem, and then Lord Shiva asked him to go on to the Tirumala and then do tapas there, and he wanted a mantra for that, and Lord Shiva gave him Rama mantra. Rama Tarakam was given to him as initiation, and he went there and did the penance, it seems. But when they did Rama Taraka Mantra tapas, as a result of that, the one appeared was Lord Mahavishnu in the form of Srinivasa. He appeared for all of them and blessed them during those time zones. This is what the Purana says. During this Kali Yuga, he came to stay there for some time. But before that, he was coming on and off and was going. As Varaha Swarupa, he was there. But when people were doing penance, he was not appearing to them as Varaha, but he was appearing as Lord Vishnu. He used to come in a flight, probably in his own flight. And the name of the flight was Ananda. Ananda Vimana. Now also he stays in Ananda Vimana. Then you may question, is this the Vimana you're talking about, the flight? Yes. I'll tell you some interesting point. I am probably, either you might have read or not, I don't know. But I will give you a very interesting point to you all. There is a scripture called Bharadvaja Vaimanika Shastram. Means the flight technology was written by Bharadvaja. Of course, this is an old text piece which was found in France, and a part of that brought to back India, and now it is available in our country also. It was taken by French people during 15th century and was well preserved there, and they developed that. In those days, one of the scientists, because they were not do any kind of experiments in public, because they used to be prosecuted, probably they used to be sentenced also in those days. So this guy went into the case, and then he was doing all kinds of research, keeping these books with them, and then he drew some drawings also basing on this book in the case. And those drawings, you know, how did they appear? They were just like our temple vimanas.